introducing Bozo, the world's most famous clown.
A funny clown, I like to travel round and round the circuits in my home. I always seem to roam. In a rocket ship I soar, I explore the ocean floor, but you must know I never go unless you come along. Bozo, Bozo, always laughs, never frown. Bozo, Bozo, Bozo the clown. As you see, I've got my pal Zany Zebra here, and we're having a little ride right around the circus ground. Let me unhatch you or unhook you there, whatever they do there. Have you ever had a zebra take you for a ride? Well, we went for a nice ride, didn't we, Zany? You know who else is going to be here in the circus today? Not only Zany Zebra, my new pal, but also Grandma Nellie's going to stop by. And boy, she has all kinds of exciting things planned. And my new pal, Professor Tweety Poop, will be here. We always have fun when he's around. Another try at our giant treasure chest bonus game, plus an exciting Bozo adventure that I'd like to take you on. So I hope you're set for all kinds of fun. What was that? What was that, Zany? All right, if you want, all right, tell the boys and girls he has something he'd like to tell you, all right? Zany, come over here, Zany. What do you got there? Oh, boy, you're a good mail carrier, Zany. Look at that. He's got a letter for Bozo. Thank you very much. Nice zebra, nice zebra. Boy, you don't have to sort of get everything. But all right, Zany, I'm reading. I'm just as anxious to you to see what's inside this special letter. It's from the Board of Education. Dear Bozo. Come on, Zany, now, it's my letter. You both done. How about that? Hey, that's pretty. Zany, do you realize what? That's what the Board of Education wants me to sort of teach you. They said you're the smartest zebra in the whole wide world, but you have to keep up with your lessons. So, tell you what we'll do. We'll pretend right now that we're at school and Bozo's going to try and teach you. Will you take a seat right over there, Zany, please? That's it. Nice. Easy now. Sit down. Easy, Zany. That's it. That's it. Good. Now, you sit down. Now, wait a minute. At a school, you have to have a blackboard. Let's see if I have a blackboard. Mr. Ringmaster, bring on the blackboard, will you please? They just like to have it cool. Oh, a nice blackboard. Oh, weeba-dooba-dooba-dee. Thank you. Got my chalk all set up and everything. All right. Now, Zany, the first thing let's see, what's this? All right, arithmetic. Arithmetic is something you learn at school. One and one would probably be too easy. All right, I'll ask you this. How much is 2 and 2? 2 and 2, Zany. Oh, you know it. All right, go ahead. 1, 2, 3. That's right. No, that's right. 4. That's right. For a minute. 2 plus 2 is 4. Good. That's terrific on that. Now, let's see. Spelling. Spelling is good. Are you good at spelling, Zany? Well, we'll find out. All right. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. No, that's probably too hard for a zebra. But how about a simple word like must? All right. Okay. Now you spell it, and I'll write it and see if it's right. M is right. Good. M. All right. M. Oh. I can't. 2. S. Good. 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 All right. Now. All right. What's at the end of a mouse? No, I'm no a tail's at the end of a mouse. How do you spell it? How do you spell it, Zany? That's right, E. Very good. Okay, now, we spelled mouse. We've had our arithmetic and our spelling lesson. Zany, how about this? Geography is a nice subject they teach in school. Let me ask you this. What is a volcano?
What volcano? It's a what mountain?
You know what he said? A volcano is a hot mountain with a hiccup. I never heard of that before. But hey, that's right. It is a hot mountain with a hiccup when you stop to think of it. All right, let me ask you this. Where is A volcano. Where do you find them?
In Hawaii.
Where?
In Hawaii.
That's right. You find volcanoes in Hawaii. Oh, now, Zadie, stop getting carried away. Bozo knows they do hula dances in there. What's that? You want Bozo to do it?
Well, don't mind if I do.
That's it. They do lovely dances. You're probably wondering what we're doing, but we're flying a little plane here. Doesn't this look like a plane to you? Come on, Butch, watch out where you're steering there. Steer it good, because we're in this plane, and the reason we're in it is because I just happened to see this piece of wood and the plane and the chairs, and reminded me of the time I was in the big air race. That's right. That's right. I almost lost $5,000 in that race.
Butch, remember the time we were in that race and my pal Mean Dean got into all that trouble and tried to make trouble for Bozo? Well,
you come on with this one. I know you're going to fly along and find out what happened on Funny Face A's Hoo-Dilly.
What's going on about here, Mr. Sheriff?
I'm closing the circus down, Bozo. Foreclosing.
Foreclosing? How come?
The circus is in debt, Bozo. It'll take $5,000 to get this show on the road.
Gee, Bozo, how are we going to raise $5,000? Have faith, Butchie boy. Something will turn up.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't miss the big air races today at 2 p.m. First prize will be $5,000 cash.
Gee, Bozo, that's the answer to our problem.
Yeah, simple. All we got to do is win that there air race. Bozo the Jet Ace. I'll do it, Butch. I'm looking for a speedy airplane. Something around $100.
$100? That's just the thing, friend. War surplus, formerly owned by a speedy pilot, Baron von Richthofen.
Looks like it's already broke in real good. I'll take it.
Co-pilot to pilot, ready for takeoff.
Switch on.
Contact.
A herd of birds. Yee-hoo-ee! Hope we're not too late for the big air races, Butchie boy.
Yes, sirree, folks. It's a wonderful day for the races. The planes are nearing the starting line, and here they come. And now here comes the last plane in the lineup. It's Bozo the Clown and his, whatever it is.
And whatever it is, I don't like competition.
By a mile.
2 miles.
Pardon me.
Bozo, we haven't got a chance in this crate.
Don't worry, Butchie boy. We'll give them a race for their money.
It's Mean Dean still out in front.
Dum da dum dum dee dee dum.
But what's this? Bozo takes the lead.
That does it.
Uh-oh, Bozo, here comes that Mean Dean, and he sure looks mean, if you know what I mean.
And plucky Bozo keeps plugging along, but there goes Mean Dean, the favorite, blasting past Bozo. Mean Dean rounds the pylon ahead of Bozo, makes a complete lap, and now is in back of the flying clown.
Out of my way, funny face. Move over. One side, Roadhog. That corny clown.
I'm tired of being a nice guy. I'll get rough.
Golly, Bozo, he shot off our top wing and wheels.
Yeah, he's making a streamline.
We're going twice as fast now, Bozo.
Thanks, Mr. Mean Dean.
What have I done? He asked for it. I'll give him the full treatment. The big gun.
Oh, he shot a hole plumb through this airplane, Butch. I feel a draft.
Now I'll finish off that clown with this little bundle. A present from me to you, clowny.
Oh, Nelly, it's a bundle of dynamite. Bozo, throw it away, quick. Butch, I dropped the dynamite in the plane. Golly, it's rolling to the tail. Bozo, the dynamite's stuck in the tail of the plane. What are we going to do? Butchy boy!
This just ain't my day! The winner is Bozo the Clown!
Jet pilot Bozo, that is! Gee, Bozo, now we can get the show back on the road! Yeah, the boss will get a bang out of our jet plane! See what I mean, Butchy boy?
Jiminy Kazooks! Bozo's been pumping this pippin' puppin' pumper over here because we're getting ready for an exciting game we play in the Bozo TV Big Top. Wowie! Professor Tweetin' Poopin' there, is there enough air in our little teeny ball there? We got a little tiny ball. Okay, bring it in. Oh, Nelly, look at that.
That's big enough.
Thank you, Professor.
You got it. Okay.
Wowee, kazowie. Have you ever seen a ball as big as that? We've been pumping it for hour after hour, and we got all the air in it to play our Bozo Balloon Bouncer game. Have you got our players all set, Mr. Ringmaster? Bring them in so we can find out who they are. Come over here and say hi to everyone. Hi, Ray. How are you today? Oh, it's a pleasure shaking hands with you. You can let go of my hand now, Ray, please. And hi, Tony. How are you doing?
Good.
Oh, I like those Bozo hats. Look terrific on you. Danny, nice meeting you. It's a pleasure shaking hands with you. Let's just see if you have a squeak. Yeah, a little bit of one. Hi, Mark. How are you doing? All right. I tell you with the red Bozo hats, get on this side. With the blue Bozo hats, on that side. This is how we play the game. It's very simple. Bozo will be the referee. I'll toss the ball once to you and then once to you. And the idea for you, with your fist, to try and push this big bouncy ball over their heads. And this team, the red team, is going to try and push it over your heads. Understand how to do it? Move closer just a little bit, boys. That's right. You stay there and a little closer. All right, ready? I'm going to put it in the middle. Hands out of your pockets. Ready? Here we go. Get it quickly. Oh, right off bounce. Bring it back in here. No score on that one. All right, here we go again. Ready? Oh, out of bounds, okay, but overhead. Still tie score. Wait a minute. Holy smoly, wait a minute. Wait on 1 second over here and we'll get through. All right, the referee has to start the game, and here we go. Oh, I think, wait a minute, okay, 1 point for the red team. All right, this time I'll throw the ball to you to start it like I did that. How's everything? Ready to go? Ready? Here we go. Whoa! Out of bounds over there. Bring it back. Still 1-0. Boy, you don't want to let it rest, do you? Here we go. Last time. Out of bounds. All right, what? Gets away from it every time. One more time. Over the head, hey! Well, I don't know. I think we got a tie score there, Mr. Ray. Bring in some Bozo Pops for all my pals. Let's see them all there. For each of our members, since we have some doubly goodly good Bozo Pops for each of the players. Thanks for playing our Bozo Balloon Bouncer game. Why don't you go see Mr. Ringmaster? He'll have some prizes for you. Mr. Ringmaster, throw in that big bouncy ball of me, will you? Thank you very much. Wait, I missed it, boy. You know, Bozo's pretty good at balancing and everything. Now, what I thought I'd try and do is balance this ball right on Bozo's shiny red nose. Can I do it? Let's see. Wait a minute. Bend right up there just a little bit, balancing on the nose. Oh, Billy!
You Yoo-hoo! Professor! Yoo-hoo! Oh, he's so cute!
Oh!
Hello, Professor
Tootin'! Hi, Grandma Nelly! How are you today?
How are you, Professor Tootin' Fooper?
No! Not Professor Tootin' Fifa! It's just Tweety for Tweety! For Fooper! Tweet Fooper! That's my own name!
Open Tutor, that's right. Yeah.
What have you got there?
Oh, wait!
Grandma Nelly?
Wait a minute, put your hand out there again! Oh, look at
my
that.
My hands put out.
Yes, your hands. Look, you need a manicure.
I do need a manicure.
You need your fingernails done. That's the thing today.
I think I'm too busy.
Yeah, well, I have a special manicure thing.
How much?
Oh, it's very inexpensive. It doesn't cost anything. And for you, it'll be free even.
Well, in that case,
I'll hold on to this. And this will trim your fingernails. What color would you like them done?
Well, how about green and blue?
Well, no, how about blue and black?
That's a
good color.
That's good.
Oh, are they going to be black and blue? All right, now, let me just hold these down. Just move over there. Yeah. Just move away. Move away just a little further.
I want a nice black and blue.
No, they'll be black and blue. Black and blue. Black are and you blue. Ready?
I'm going to get it, please.
You're going to get it. Oh, I shouldn't have done it. I'm a naughty nanny.
Oh, hi, Professor. I was just... Well, what in the world is that?
Oh, hi, Mr. Bozo. You're going to like this. This is a manicure machine.
One of your new inventions?
Yeah, I rented it. And it manicures your fingers real nice.
Manicures Bozo's fingernails?
Would you like to have it?
Well, I always like to keep my fingernails nice and clean.
Nice and clean.
That'll be a ding-dong dandy out there.
Would you like blue and green colors?
Blue and green? Well, I don't know. Do you think blue and green? How about, blue? Blue is good because it goes with my suit, my Bozo suit.
Woo-hoo! You're going to get it. Now you hold this. Yes. And
what do I do? You mean I just hold this?
Hold this and just step back a little bit. And step back a little bit more.
Professor?
Step a little bit.
Back a little bit more?
Yeah. Now, wait. I forgot something. I think you better hold this way.
Yeah. All right. Okay. All right.
And step more back. Oh, he's going to get it.
I hope he knows what he's doing.
Step one more step.
Okay, one more step.
One more step.
Okay.
And one more step. And one
back,
more
back,
step.
Okay.
And he's going to get it black and blue. I think it's time now to let go.
Did you say let go, Professor?
Yes.
Okay. Professor!
You had to snap and sleep on my fingers.
What would happen, Professor? I hope everything's all right. I guess one thing for sure, you got a big bang out of that, didn't you? Hey, that's pretty good. You did get a bang out of it. Time once again here in the center ring of the circus for the Bozo Bonus Treasure Chest Game. Whoa-wee! A giant treasure chest of toys for some lucky boy girl. Well, first of all, let's find Boot. Boot, what I'd like you to do is to close your eyes real tight and put your hand right inside there, and pick out one of the numbers. Just one. All right, let's find out who it's going to be to win this treasure chest of toys. It's number 40. 40. Oh, that's 41. 41. One off there. Oh, this girl back here. Thank you very much. Hi, Peggy. How are you? Boy, it's nice seeing you. Let's just check one thing. Yeah, I thought you did. You have a little bit of a squeak? Just a little bit of a one. Do you see that treasure chest of toys? Well, they're going home with you if you can do this special game that we have for our bonus game today. Bring in the hoops, Mr. Ringmaster. There they are in the center of the ring. The object of this game is to take this balloon and throw it either through this hoop or through that hoop. If you get it through any one of those hoops once, you win the whole treasure chest of toys. You stand right on the edge of the ring, you throw it through, but once you throw it, you have to go and get it and come back to the starting line. Understand, Peggy? All right, let me set them up for you. It'd be kind of easy if I just held them like this. So what I do is give it a little spin. That's what I do. Ready? Here we go. All right, just go get it. Go ahead, Peggy. Go get it. There it is. Get it right back here. Oh, don't throw it away from her because you're not helping her. Come on, Peggy. Quick as you know, back over here. Over here, Peggy. Right from here. Almost. I'm trying again now, Peggy. You just have to get through once. Stand at the starting line. One more time. Take a good aim. Oh, one more time. Oh, Peggy, the time has run out. Even though you didn't win the whole treasure chest, come with me, a Peggy Weggy, and look what we have for you. A beautiful Scrabble game for juniors. I know you're going to enjoy it. Thank you for trying our bonus treasure chest game. What a lovely looking young lady that is. Boy, I tell you, I just realized, Mr. Ringmaster, we got to add another prize to the treasure chest, because when nobody wins our bonus game, we keep piling toy after toy after toy into the treasure chest. Let's add that. That's kind of exciting for some boy. We'll put our, ooh, Lily, that's a heavy one, our super crane toy right in here. And then we'll have another try tomorrow at our treasure chest of toys for some lucky boy or girl. And wowee, will they be happy. Hoo-hoo-wee. Grandma Nellie, Professor Tweety Pooper, wait!
Hi, Mr. Bozo!
Wait! Well, wait, give me my balloon!
We are having fun, Mr. Bozo!
Well, you were playing the nice game, and I thought it'd be nice if you shared it with Bozo!
Oh, yeah, why not? Let's do it!
Hey, do that again! Hey, that's pretty nice! All right, I'll tell you, how do we play? You're doing it with your head?
You hold to me, and I hold to you, and he's holding to him, and he's I hold to you.
Good. Don't let it get away from you, though, okay? Ready? Here we go.
Oh, my.
Oh, oh, look, I tell you, Professor, whoa, Nelly, wait, we'll get the balloon back in just a minute, but I did want to remind you that we'll see you again next time for all kinds of exciting circus balls. Till then, remember what your pal Bozo